Good morning, all of you are warm welcome to attend today's Heart and Soul Programs of India Perpetual Life Ministry. And I'm thankful to my God for this opportunity for me to share with you something from the Word of God. As the Word of God is encouraging us and motivating us to live our daily life, thank Lord what He has done to us. I'm thinking how did people are managing their crisis period. So the world has many pictures of various crises. Like we are also undergoing a corona pandemic season or period. This epidemic period equip people to value themselves as well as value others. So therefore, a life within a home is a supreme life. Now, the people may feel that living single is more powerful. But Bible never advocates to live as a single. Single can't live in this world. In Genesis chapter 1 verse 18 says, it's not good for a man to be leave alone. So we need to understand the significance of that word. Though God created man and woman in His own likeness, and God expected every person not to leave as a single person. And chapter 2 verse, we can see that chapter 2 verse 18 says, what he says about God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper or comparable to him. That a suitable match. We talk about it as a Lord's endorsement for marriage life. Why marriage is significant in this light of this word? It's not good for a man to be alone. So God is expecting a fellowship. I would like to share with you few elements of a fellowship. So we may feel that marriage is the only place we have fellowship. No, we have a fellowship. If you read the first epistle of John, chapter 1, 5 to 9, 10 verse, it says, this is the message which we have heard from Him and declared to that God is light and in Him no darkness at all. And verse 6 says, if we say that we have fellowship with Him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. Because God is already recognized that He is a light. But we are living in the darkness. That means we don't have any fellowship with the light, fellowship with God. If you say that one, that is a lie. Seventh verse says, but if you walk in the light as He is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Christ, His Son, cleanses us from all the sins. That is a very precious word. That is what verse 7 says. If we walk in the light, as He is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. So when we are living in the light of God, we can see the next person. In darkness, we could not identify who they are. In the darkness, we cannot identify who we are. The darkness makes you blind. You are a blind person. You cannot identify anything, recognize anything else. You cannot sense anything else. There is no question of sense. There is no question of understanding. There is no question of identification. There is no question of identity. In darkness, nothing is work out there. But everything will be work out when the light shines. John says, he knows Jesus. He says that He is a light. So we need to have such an understanding. Jesus is a light for me. Whenever you find darkness in your life, whenever you find a difficulty in your life, whenever you find ups and downs in your life, you look the light Jesus. John say, you will get all understanding there. Do you know why these things are happening? In this normal corona period, we are asking this question, why these things are happening? There are reasons. The whole world is filled with a lot of ungodly matters now. It's true that there are a lot of evidences. This novel coronavirus is not come out of the nature. It has been developed in an unnatural way. And it has broken the boundaries. It has spread all over the world, and the world is under this big threat now. Look on the light of God, then we can see. So what our focus today is to have a fellowship with the light. How to have a fellowship with this light? If we say that we have a light and we are walking in the light, if we are not understanding the light which is mentioned here, Jesus, we are telling lies. Don't tell lies, because God wanted us to live in this light. Verse 7 says that, if we walk in the light as He is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. We need to have fellowship with another. This is not a question of social distancing. We can have fellowship with people through many means and medias. And one thing it's mentioned here, if you say we have no sin, again we are deceiving ourselves, the truth is not in us. That's the one thing we can prove, that there's no truth in us. And the most significant word says in the 9th word regarding this fellowship, if we confess our sins, God is faithful to forgive our all sins, your major sins, your minor sins, your sin in the past, sin in the future, and sin in this time. Because the cleansing of Jesus is sufficient. The blood of Jesus Christ to wash away all your sins. That's what the verse says. Verse 7 says, the blood of Jesus Christ, His Son, cleanses from all the sins. Those who are living with the guilty, don't worry. Go to Jesus, confess it, get the cleansing, simple method. That is important for us to experience from our fellowship. I would like to share with you the purpose of fellowship. So purpose is to have a fellowship, is to glorify God. So we need to have a unity. God never wants you to live as a single. You to live with the unity of people. Unity is strength. Unity brings power. As a community we have a unity. As a nation we have unity. As a group we have a unity. We know, we recognize. Number one is that the believer is encouraged in growing in Christ. That's one of the reason behind it. In Romans chapter 1 verses 11 and 12 says, I long to see you so that I may impart you some spiritual gift to make you too strong, that you and I may be mutually encouraged by each other's faith. Don't encourage other by your negative statements, negative communications. Encourage each other with the faith. I have seen, I have noticed, I have experienced the faith. The believers are exchanging the word of faith, not exchanging the mistake of others' life. It's not a time of judgment. You are nobody to judge others. So it's a time to exchange the faith, the word of faith to each other. That is one purpose of our fellowship. Second one, the world should come to know that Jesus Christ is our Lord. That's a picture it has given in John chapter 7, verses 22 and 23, saying like, I have given them the glory that you have given me. And they may be one as we are one. I in them and you are in me. May they be brought to complete unity to let the world know that you sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me. These verses are explained very clearly about I give them my glory. Now we are carrying the glory of His Son, Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus was carrying the glory of God. Jesus transferred that glory to us. That we can see in the life of people, life of the church, life of fellowship. And we need to understand the conditions of this fellowship. Number one, the basic commitment to love each other. In Romans chapter 12 verse 10 also, Paul wrote to a letter to this Roman, says very clearly, be devoted to one another in brotherly love. Honor one another above yourself. Honor others as better than yourself. Respect people. Honor each other. I think this is a very, very crucial element in our life and our society. Even within the family, if the wife honors husband, 50% problem will be going to be finished. Recently, I have 2 days back, I have dealt with a problem. The wife, she was a government nurse here. The husband working with an ordinary company, both are working. But wife was, luckily she got around 65,000 rupees as monthly salary. But this poor husband, the private company gave him only 15,000 rupees. But she said that I am getting more salary, I must get all honor from people. You must honor me. You must give me the full money. I'll be taking control of the finance of our family. Two sons, small children, 8 and 11 years old. Now husband say, I'm the husband. I'm the ruler of this family. You should give me that fund so that I can manage. We can think about the future of my sons. She said, no. I'm getting more. Not honoring, not understanding each other. Here is a big problem. So, honor each other, devote to one another in brotherly love. So, without this basic truth, we cannot develop a fellowship. And second one, our fellowship must be based on our commitment. That must be under the base of agape. Agape means unconditional love. Don't say about your conditions. If you say condition, they also will ask you conditions. Conditional love is very limited. It cannot operate all the time. It will depends on the conditions like a contract. Marriage started with the conditions. Husband should love wife and wife should submit to husband. That's a condition should be there. But once we get into that contract, marriage will fly upon it, go beyond these descriptions. So that the husband and wife should understand very clearly of this fellowship is based on agape love. So our fellowship must be and should be like that. And John chapter 13 verse 34, the word of God is supporting, a new commandment I give you, love one another. Very easy. Love one another. When we love a person, that must include the strength of the person, the positive of the person, the goodness of the person, the beauty part of that person at the same time. Equally, look on the other aspects. The friends of the job came to console this person. And finally, all they got angry with him. They looked the negative parts. They said that you make yourself a greater person. We don't agree with you. You are a sinner. You are eligible to be in this situation. Undergo this kind of sickness. You are eligible for this punishment. But finally, God said, if this Job prays, you will be saved. Because he is a man, I know him very well. Don't judge with that person. The conditions of this fellowship, God say, the mutual understanding should be there. And the love each other, mutual love should be there. And the third position is a true fellowship. That means a true fellowship means a true Christ-oriented life. Christ-centered life. That's what the Philippians chapter 2 verses 1 and 2 and First John chapter 1 verse 3 also says that we have seen and heard, we declare to you that you may also have fellowship with us. Truly our fellowship is with the Father and with His Son Jesus Christ. What makes a family who depend on God? They're very special. Christ-oriented family is very special because all it is properly connected. The fellowship means it is connected. It is registered in the heaven. It called license from the heaven. God is a supplier of wisdom and power and mercy and love. Once you register with God, your abundance of love, it comes to you as a flow. It's overflowing love. Husband and wife should be like a new persons because they are a new creations. They could show a magnificent way of life in this world. The family is filled with a lot of spiritual fruits. Terrenals like a wine branches. They'll be more fruitful, more hope in this family. More leaders of the society will come out of this family. Many things we can say about this family if it's a Christ-oriented family. So also we have to understand that this fellowship must walk in the light. What all the subject we are discussing in our fellowship? I know many fellowships. They are meeting for drinking together, eating together, making pleasure together, nothing creative. But this fellowship is actually walking in the light. In the light they can see others. In the light they can see the reality. In the light they can look at the people around. David Livingstone, when he heard about the people of Africa, those period, 18 centuries, they led a very pagan life. They ate people, man to man. They kill each other. The tribes will kill each other for their food also. Can you imagine such a situation? They kill other tribes for their food. They're eating people's flesh. Such a notorious barbarian activity has happened in Africa. When Dave Livingstone listened to that, he went to Africa. He got many force to come back to England. Why should you suffer? When he was living in the light, he saw the people in his area, in African areas, perishing. They did not know what they have done there. He gave them the light. Many people got angry. Why you are preaching gospel? Because if gospel is light. Without giving light, how can we preach about other things there? They preach the gospel. That's what we need to powerfully preach the gospel. Give the light to people. Then in the light of gospel, they can see what is reality. Not some information. That light should give them the burden, passion. They'll be more empathetical. Though they have sympathy, but they are more empathetical. Empathetical means they have more participation to help the people to come out from the difficulties. If they are coming together, the group will be powerful. They will be adopt nations. They will be adopt people. They will adopt most critical conditions. Even in our country, the drought comes, the flood comes, the group of people assisted our government, the people of these groups, they made a lot of effort to people to survive. We cannot ignore the importance of this group. So, we have to understand the essentials of to experience the the fellowship. And another one is obedience to the light. Once we see the light, we have to be more obedient to the light. We cannot ignore it. In Luke chapter 15 says, a man was wounded by robbers. He was sitting the roadside. The priest came. Priest looked at his watch. And he said, I don't have the time to take care of this man. He left. He said that God is more important person to me rather than man. He never felt a fellowship with this man. He felt a fellowship with God. He was satisfying with his limited religious relationship. That's a fake religion. That's a fake fellowship. That's what Jesus mentioned, that one. Jesus only mentioned, who is a true friend? So if you read Luke chapter 15, we can see that one. Also, we can understand in real fellowship, what will happen? 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 22 says, 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 22 says, now that you have purified yourself by obeying the truth, so that you have a sincere love for your brothers. Love one another deeply from the hearts. The real genuine love should come from the heart. The Peter said, Saint Peter said, it has come from your heart. That's a real meaning of being together. And also we have to understand the fellowship will be creating such a genuine interest in others' well-being. Genuine interest in others' well-being. I know there are a lot of people in our countries adopting people, adopting villages. There is a village called Kedakambalam, in the south part of, central part of Kerala side, Kedakambalam. That one person name is Sabu. His father started a small company which started to making the aluminium vessels. He got a loan from one of his friend's company, financial company. That became a bank, federal bank. He got a 10,000 loan from that federal bank. Then he started this vessel factory. Now, you know what happened? The Lord blessed that company. Now the company was willing to share their profit to others. Especially they have adopted one full panchayat. All the people, all the members of that panchayat will get complete food grains, food items, what all a family needed, everything they will get for only 30% of its real cost. A milk packet is available for 5 rupees. Sugar packet 1 kg is 10 rupees, like that. Now the people of that panchayat is having more hope. They feel oneness. They avoid all the criminal activities. They avoid unwanted politics there. Now the people feel more freedom, more peace there. They don't have the tension. They feel that this Anna Aluminium Company is taking care of us. So we need to understand the inspiration of this, love one another. This is a real meaning of this fellowship. A genuine interest in others' well-being is one of the points, and also willingness to lay down one's life. In John chapter 15 verse 12 and 13, John chapter 15 verse 12 and 13, Jesus said, my command is this, love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that one lay down his life for his friends. Give his life for friends. That is the greatest love the world can show. That also has come through this word fellowship. And fellowship in the church means that has different, nothing different. It is in Acts chapter 4 verse 32 says, they were all in one heart, one spirit. Then they were in one soul, one mind. And they followed the physical expression of having all things in common. They distributed to all people in common. That's the meaning of fellowship. The fellowship is workable. Fellowship is so interesting. Fellowship gives people. That will give people to live together. God expects you to leave as a team in the home, in a society. Share what all the blessings you received and express your love in God. May the good God shower with all these blessings through the fellowship. Thank you so much for watching today's Heart and Soul program. May the God bless you. Thank you.